Welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox One. This is the beginning of several tutorials focused on ship design. We're starting with small grid and we're starting from the beginning. We are playing in creative to speed up the process. In regular mode, in survival, you're going to have to collect all the components and do all that stuff to be able to build things. But this has been designed to give you an idea on how to get started with your first ever ship. And we're going to need a bit of a platform to build from. Not too big, so I'm going to just place down some large grid light armor blocks to begin with. So I've got somewhere to start building on. It's a lot easier to do it this way. And what you'll notice is you've got several controls. You can rotate blocks. You can change the axis of rotation. And you can change the type of block off the D-pad. Now there are modifiers to this. If you hold down the left bumper, you'll change your shortcuts. You can then bring your blocks forwards and backwards with up and down on the D-pad. You can turn auto rotation mode on and off with right on the D-pad, and symmetry mode on and off with left on the D-pad. You can also hold down the left bumper and tap X to change the grid size between large and small grid. And left bumper and X rather than left bumper and Y. Left bumper and Y is going to toggle your dampener state on and off. Okay, so when building ships, first of all, you're going to need something to start the ship off. Now, you can start off with landing gear. You'll notice that that landing gear is a honking big landing gear. Too big for our needs. So if we tap left bumper and X, you can make a small landing gear. And then you can rotate that small landing gear so it's facing downwards. And it will lock. What this won't do though is when you're building your ship, this won't power your ship from your base. So we want, this won't bother too much in terms of creative mode, but always make sure when you're building, I've covered this before in other tutorials, that you're building on a powered grid, because you don't want Space Engineers to perform a cleanup and remove your grid. As I said though, this will not charge any batteries on the ship, so if you get away with it, start building a ship using a rotor. Grind off the head. This is another reason we attach a battery. You want to add a small head. Now, you can see we can start looking at building a ship off this rotor. Another thing when you make rotors, your default building platform is they will charge a grid. What you want to do though is you want to put rotor lock on. You don't want your ship spinning around like mad. Anyway. First thing, once you've got your gantry as high as you want to start laying down an axis. Now I've got building with line mode on, and again I've got different videos on this channel telling you how to do it. Briefly though, clicking the right stick, you can see toggle multi-block building, ensure that's set to line, confirm it, and you're good to go. Cockpits, your first order of business. Cockpits are three blocks wide. Now, if you're on atmospheric planets, you won't need to worry at all about oxygen, but we're in space. So we want cockpit. Now if you look, the cockpit has two ports, and we're going to want some way of getting oxygen to that ship. We need gas and logistics, an O2 H2 generator. Now if you look at this model as we're placing it down as the ghost, you'll see two ports there. If you align that to the back of your little vessel, that will now provide oxygen to the cockpit, as long as it's got ice. Next thing we want, since we're going to be dealing with a ship like this, want to work out how big it's going to be. I do want a little bit of cargo space on it, so I'm going to pop a medium cargo container. And again, it has two ports, front and back. No ports on the upper and lower, but two on the side. So you want to align these ports together like that. So now you've got that. What we want now are, let's just say to begin with, and again since we're in space it doesn't really matter, we're going to have a couple of batteries. And this is just a simple build. You see it there, look. A couple of batteries to provide power. And we want a way to recharge this little shuttle. To begin with, so we want to slap a connector on the back like that. Now we've got our connector on the back. Next thing we want to have a look at is it's going to need some way of making it turn. A couple of things you want to put on, and as you build ships, obviously you will learn to build things your own way. But you want a gyroscope, and I like to place them down the axis of a ship. And just in case you're going to make this remote control at any point, and also just so you can find it, makes it a lot easier. Actually, we'll have the antenna sticking up like that, to pop an antenna on it. So this ship can tootle about with a gyroscope, but it still can't fly. You're going to need thrust. You're going to need thrust, and you're going to need only a small amount, because you're in space. We're not making this to do anything amazing. Let's have a look then. We want iron thrusters, and we want the regular iron thruster, and you want thrust in every direction. So one there. We're not building with symmetry mode. One there. So I'm not too fussed in that regard. One there. And one there. So we've got forward and we've got backwards. Now we want some way to make this ship go up, and we also want a way to make it go down. And last but not least, we want to be able to move from side to side. Like so. So this little shuttle now has everything it needs to move around. It doesn't yet have any landing gear, but that's fine. It doesn't really need it, because it's only a little demonstration shuttle. And if we leave it on the rotor for the moment, you'll see. If we flick the left stick, the battery power changes. One thing it might need, just so we can see where we're going, first pop a little light either side. And then spotlight on the front. When you're ready to cut your creation free, and I mean, this is a very basic design. But as you can see, it can fly around. It can get you from place to place. It'll be oxygenated. You can turn the lights on and off if you want. Especially the front spotlight, if you hold down on the D-pad or up on the D-pad or whatever direction you want, and you can find the lights by tapping the left or the right bumper, choose spotlight and choose toggle block on and off. Turn the spotlight on and off. And that's our little shuttle. Controlled with the stick. Left, right, up, down. Right on the stick to spin around. As you can see, the gyroscope does a really good job. If you want to roll the ship, hold down the left bumper and hit the right stick. Just like the jetpack. This will make a nice little shuttle to get you from A to B. Say you've been doing a little bit of mining, you've got some cargo, you want it to drop it off on your base. See you doing it in your suit. A nice oxygenated environment. You could just flip back over. And if there's nothing in the way as well, you'd be able to park upon your connector here. Reverse in, lock onto that, use the solar panels and the base power to charge your little shuttle. That's your very, very basic shuttle. If you're in atmosphere, you'd be using atmospheric thrusters, and the same deal would apply. You probably need a few more atmospheric thrusters, because depending on the weight of your little ship, you might need a couple of, you probably need more thrusters on the up. I suggest putting downward thrusters on now, in atmosphere that is, because if you decide to stick a remote control block on this, the remote control won't know what to do if it doesn't have all thrusters in the requisite directions. It'll get confused. And the same deal for any remote ship. Make sure it has all the thrusters on. But really, that is your little ship tutorial. It'll do the job. It's not meant to land because you're in space. You can hop out of it. That's all for this particular tutorial on small grid shipbuilding. This isn't the only one. There will be more, and we'll go more in depth. We will go to my Earth planet, and we will have a look at how to make a ship that can get you from the Earth planet into space. I've got a couple of working models in that regard. One of them I built on a stream. If you look at the channel, you'll see the skeleton of that ship when I was streaming building. And that will give you an idea. We'll go over what I think you need to be able to generate enough fuel, not only to get you out of the atmosphere, but to help get you around in space and also back to the planet. As always, stay safe, have fun, happy engineering. I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.